Welcome back to the show. Let's take a look at what's making international headlines now. Donald Trump's dominant march towards the Republican nomination continues. The former president defeating rival Nikki Haley in the South Carolina primary.
US correspondent Lauren Tomasi is following this story for us. Lauren, Trump's win highlights his incredible grip on the Republican Party, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and it also highlights the fact that Donald Trump is almost certainly going to become the next Republican presidential candidate. Trump this morning celebrating that landslide victory in the state of South Carolina. He secured around 60% of the votes compared to his rival Nikki Haley, who only got around 39%. So it was an absolute walloping. And Donald Trump is very clearly looking straight ahead to the general election in November. He appears to think he has this in the bag, and by all intents and purposes, he certainly does. Last night in his victory speech, he made no mention of Nikki Haley, instead targeting President Joe Biden.
We're going to be up here on November 5th, and we're going to look at Joe Biden. And we're going to look him right in the eye. He's destroying our country. And we're going to say, Joe, you're fired. Get out. Get out, Joe. You're fired.
Lauren, Nikki Haley's refusing to bow out. I guess she could be a running mate.
She could, but look, she isn't bowing out just yet. She is the sole rival for Donald Trump, and her refusal to step down in this race despite losing puts her in a bit of a unique position. She is that losing candidate who just won't step away, and we haven't seen certainly a modern prominent candidate like Nikki Haley, who has been on such a losing streak, just refused to bow out of the race in South Carolina. That absolute walloping by Donald Trump in her home state. South Carolina is a place where Nikki Haley was twice governor, and yet she says she's going to stay in this Republican candidate race. She says it's at least until Super Tuesday that she's going to hang in. That is next month, a day when there will be 15 states right across America going to the polls for their primary votes. But look, the next stop is just 2 days away. It's Michigan. And whether or not Nikki Haley will receive any traction there, it is unlikely. But the show is never over in America.
Well, no. They tend to be over when you run out of sponsorship money.
Yes, exactly. When the millions stop rolling in. Thanks, Lauren.
Welcome back. Well, there's been another big win for Donald Trump, the former US president winning a crucial vote in the state of South Carolina.
And it makes no one more happy than US political commentator Pete Dominick, who joins us from you. Can't wipe the smile off his face this morning. Pete, you okay, buddy?
Carl, Sarah, no, I'm doing good because the truth is, let me give you the spin. The guy should have won everybody, but he only won about 60% of the vote, and that other 40% of Republicans, these are Republican voters, in a state that, by the way, they're so conservative, you know, they want to swap the stars on our flag out with guns and Christian symbolism, and they didn't vote for Trump, so it's not that bad news. That's the spin, Carl, Sarah.
I mean, I like that spin, Pete, but the reality is, this is Nikki Haley. She was supposed to win this state. She didn't.
And she's not going anywhere. She's going to stay in because she has all this money to still run. She's not going anywhere. She was the governor of that state twice, and she won 40% of the vote last night. And she's not leaving. She wants to remain a thorn in his side and see if he goes to jail.
You know, even if he does that, he can still win and pardon himself from inside the big house. I mean, no matter what way you look at it, Trump is here to stay, at least until the end of the year.
It is so great to talk to American legal expert, Carl. You nailed it. I've got to bring you on. Got to bring you on my show to analyze. He's going to pardon himself from jail. He's going to reach through that little hole. He's like, you know what? I am in an orange jumpsuit. But if you can you hear me? I'd like to pardon myself. Thank you.
He's doing it in his own shoes.
I know. I mean, he's changed his shoes, Pete. That changes the game.
Yeah, no, he's selling shoes to his old white supporters. Who's buying these shoes? He couldn't be more off base. He made like 1,000 shoes. It's a grift like everything else that he does. It's a lie like everything else that he does. He's taking his donors' money and using it for his legal fees. He owes $500 million now to a New York civil court. The man is in deep, deep trouble. I'm not worried. I am prepared to move into David Campbell's garage if he loses and become his,
plenty of room.
His nanny.
It's going to be a busy garage. I mean, there's a whole lot of people going to move out. I mean, the reality is that he's probably going to give it a shake.
he's absolutely going to be the nominee. There's no doubt about it. That's been no surprise. But because he is leading still, he's leading this cult of people who are anti-democracy, who don't believe the outcome of our elections. We're in bad shape in the United States of America in terms of how divided we are over reality. Guys, I always call it Earth 1 and Earth 2. It's not Republicans and Democrats or liberal versus conservative. It's those of us that I think live in reality, and then there's a certain percentage, not a high percentage, not half of them, about 30% of Americans who think the moon is made of cheese and men never walked on it.
It isn't?
Oh, that would be tasty.
Is that Charlesburg?
I just, like, wow. Spoiler alert, Carl.
It's flat to the earth.
Hey,
you
look,
can walk.
I'll come and visit you at the garage. It'll be a fun garage, DC's place. Good on you, mate. Thank you so much.
We're going to have a riot.
Wow. They're feeling it, aren't they?
I know.
Anyway.